Hey everyone, Tom here. Welcome back to another Drive With Me video. I haven't recorded one of these in a while because I've had a couple backed up because I've been ill over the last couple of days and weeks. Thinking about it, I haven't recorded in like a week or two. But hope you guys are enjoying life. I definitely kind of am. But I'm going to get into that topic today. Today's topic is my car modified? Now, I'm going to go with no. Engine-wise, no, but kinda, but I'll get into that in a sec. Looks-wise, yes. So let's get into these topics. So, is my car modified by looking at it? Appearance-wise, I mean, yes. I have installed wind deflectors. My back lights tinted a bit and back windows tinted a little bit. That was actually on the car when I got it, when I brought the car, and I added the wind deflectors on it. I also have a poppy on the front of my car so I know it's mine when I lose it in a car park. You know, one of those like stick-on poppy things. So I guess if you ever see a Corsa with a poppy on it, you might think it's mine. Who knows? I'm going to disclose my location. Sorry about those lights. They are quite bright. Let's get into the, is my engine modified? Now, some people say that a black box is a modification. Now, I do have a black box. I did a separate video on that, so if you want to check that out, go back through the videos and you'll find it. But I don't really count it as a mod. I kind of count it as like a battery drainer for me, and it has drained my battery before, which I probably should have added in that video, but I kind of did it after that. But if you want to count that as a mod, then yeah. But the reason why I say kinda is because when I bought the car, it had an engine in it, obviously, because you need a bit of drive. But that engine blew up. The four-cylinder blew up. Like, the cylinder just exploded. The valve went into the cylinder and then into the piston, and then the piston exploded within the cylinder. That's what happened. So the valve went into the piston couldn't go up and down, exploded, and blew up. Like, blew the whole cylinder up, and I couldn't start the car. It would run on three cylinders, but I didn't really want to try it, and I do go really slow now because of that fact, and which is the black box, of course. But the reason why I said kinda, if I had a modification to my engine, it has a new engine. This car does have a new engine. It's the same engine, it's just from an older car. And I have told the DVLE, so don't tell me that in the comments down below. I have to tell them, because I do already know, because the garage did tell them. And that's basically all the mods I can really think about. And I have a blind spot little mirrors on my actual car mirrors, which I'm kind of learning not to use anymore after about a couple of, almost a year of driving. I'm learning how to not use them. So in my next car, I don't have to get more, because they're like £7.99 each. So, you know. But I do admit the blind multiple mirrors are quite nice. Stuff that I would do to this car if I was going to modify it. Let's get into that. My current wheels are silver, or chrome. Silver, chrome, pretty silver. I'd love to make them black. Just matte black wheels. I just think it would look so nice. Another thing I'd like to put black is my wing mirrors and my roof. Get a wrap or something like that for those, and I'd be happy with that, because I think that these cars do look nice. But I don't know, I feel like wrapping it's going to be a lot of money, and I don't really want to plastic dip the wheels, or wrap the wheels, or spray paint the wheels, but I do like the look of Corsas with black wheels and black wings. Also, looking on the appearance of the car, I would like to put the is it a VXR spoiler? Basically, the spoiler that's on the VXR of Corsas from this generation of car, which is 2009. I'd love to put that spoiler color match to this car on it. My next car, I am kind of looking at getting a new Corsa, and it definitely will have a spoiler if I get one of those. Or any, my next car might have a spoiler. That's a hint to anyone that has been watching. I don't know what car I'm going to get next, but I would like a spoiler. But I'm trying to think of what other stuff I'd do. I don't think I'd touch the engine unless I completely engine swapped it. Put like a Volvo engine in it or something that would fit in the bay, which wasn't produced by Volkswagen themselves. Just so it has a bit more power and, well, yeah. Now, I have this idea in my mind, which I do actually want to do a separate video on, and it's where, in the future, of course, when I actually have, like, silly amounts of money to spare, if I do have that much money, then I probably will do it, and I definitely will film it. I would like to lift a Vauxhall Corsa, like, make it into an off-roading car, like, make it all-wheel drive, put big tyres on it, lift it, put a screen in it. I mean, an old car, so it probably had, like, hundreds of thousands of miles in it, but I just think it would be really cool to see. It's like a little car turned into this big, like, off-roading thing. I don't know how street legal that would be, but I don't think I'd take it on the streets. Actually, probably wouldn't know what I'm talking about. Definitely would take it on the streets. But that's what I really want to do. But I want to do a separate video on that, I think, talking about it, because I feel like I know someone that would love to do that with me, but just not at the moment. And I'm going to give a shout out to a guy called Jesse Colligan. Collingham, I don't know his name, you can just type in Jesse on the Google searches or look at my subscription feed, you'll probably see him somewhere. He's got currently got a VXR and he's got some vented hoods. Now I wouldn't put vents in my hood because as much as it might help, I don't know, I don't really think it's going to look good. No offence to his car, because it does look good on his VXR. Next thing is that Jesse's done is he has a spoiler lip. Now, if I had a spoiler on this car, I would definitely put a lip. Like a little spoiler extension thing that he has. It just looks so good. You don't realise that I'm a bit of a fanboy to that Jesse guy, and I am a fan of Lee Lockwood. You know Lee Lockwood, you know Jesse, basically. Really bright. But yeah, that's about all the things I would do. Like, I don't know. Like, I have this thing about touching engines. Like, I wanted to do an oil change on this because it does need one. But I'm just afraid that it won't go as well as I think it will. And I'm afraid that I'll break it. Well, not break it, but like, there'll be like chunks in the oil, and then there'll be like little bits of metal, and I'll be like, ugh, now what? But I definitely want to do an oil change on this, just because I want to know how to do it myself, instead of having to pay like 75 quid to do it with someone else, and I'll probably get some oil and stuff, and I'll do a video on that, definitely. Also, I want to do a video on what's actually wrong with this car currently, and it is linked to the oil, but I talked to that in a recent video, and I'll talk to that in a separate one itself. The guy Jesse also has a Vauxhall Corsa as well. I just went over a Costa Cup. I hope nothing sharp was in that. My car is technically modded appearance-wise. It does have wind deflectors, and windows are tinted, and the back tail lights are tinted, and I believe it has an aftermarket rear bumper. I didn't know this when I bought the car or got insurance on it, so I only know that now. So my insurance company do find out then. I didn't know that it was modded, so I don't know. My dad actually helped me insure the car, and he said it wasn't modded, so I just sort of went along with him. Another thing I believe is kind of modded, which I'm going to do a video on this car, which will be very soon. I do apologise for the long wait for this thing to come out. I believe it does have a modified exhaust. I actually uploaded like a recording clip of it cold starting in a little rev sesh. I'm not going to say that word ever again. Session. The revving sort of thing. It does sound louder than it actually is. Then it probably should. I don't know why it sounds like that, or if it should even sound like that, but it definitely sounds not stock. Either there's holes in it, or some person's changed it, but as far as I'm aware, it's stock, but it doesn't sound it. And it hasn't changed when I changed the engine, so it's not the engine. So, who knows? But I think it's going to do it for this video here. Is my car modded? Yes. Appearance-wise, is it modified? Engine-wise, no, unless you count the black box as a modification. Other than that, it's not. Where is this 4B? It's like halfway up the cap. They are quite far over there. Anyway, if you want to hear me ranting about like other drivers on the road, then, you know, hit that thumbs up button. But yeah, 5 likes. Yeah, let's go for 5 likes, and I'll do a video on other drivers on the road, why I don't like certain types of drivers. But I hope you guys did enjoy this video. I hope you guys did enjoy, like I keep saying. I don't know why I repeat myself at the end of these videos, but I have to do. So I hope you guys did enjoy. In the outro, there is a video on the right of the screen, which is a link to a playlist of all my drive with me videos. And on the left of the screen, there will be a YouTube recommended video, especially for you. So I hope you guys did enjoy this Drive With Me video, and I hope to see you guys in the next one. Goodbye. See, I remember when I met you as a sophomore. Started out as friends, but I knew that we would want more. Hit your favorite restaurant with your favorite dress on. That's one of my favorite memories.